Once again, welcome to accountancy class, grade 11. So we are discussing about retribution of errors under chapter number 6. Isn't it? So the previous video, we discussed the carry balance which affect, does not, it will agree the carry balance. That means what? So it will affect any errors which affect the agreement of carry balance. Okay. So under that, there are two stages. One is before preparation of the carry balance, all we are going to rectify the error. Understood? Now, second one, after the preparation of carry balance, how to rectify the errors. Okay, that is very, very important session for this one. So, this is the session, very important one. Okay, now we are going to discuss after preparation of carry balance, how to locate the error. Okay, understood? That's what we are going to discuss now. So, the heading here, rectification of errors, after preparing the carry balance, how to locate. Locate the errors. Okay. So here, so at this stage, the errors are rectified. So we can be able to rectify after the preparation of the carry balance also, once you disclose the error. Okay. After the preparation of the carry balance. Okay. And transfer of difference in carry balance to the suspense account. That's what this session we are going to discuss. So what is the meaning of suspense account? So importance of suspense account, how the suspense account occurred. So how the simple one, any difference in carry balance, you can show as a suspense account. That's what very important session this one. So the errors at this stage are rectified. How we are going to rectify? By passing a general entry. Okay, with the respective account. Or accounts affected by error. So sometimes which accounts affected by error and the suspense account. Two things. That's what here, this session. What is the meaning of suspense account? That is a very, very important thing. Very important one also, especially for retribution of errors. Okay. So that's what very, very interesting session also. Okay. So it should be noted that errors, unless stated otherwise, that is very important. Or normally rectified, how? With the help of the suspense account. Here, we write the question. So what is the suspense account? How we are going to rectify with the help of that? That's what we are going to discuss detailed. So here, very important one. After preparing the carry balance, how to find out the error occurred. So after once locate the error, how to rectify with the help of suspense account. That's what we will discuss now. Now let's see. What is the meaning of suspense account? So what is the effect of the suspense account? We are going to discuss now. Okay. So now let us see the meaning of suspense account. The purpose began the creation of suspense account. Okay. See here. Suspense account, when we are going to prepare, after preparing the carry balance, we are going to prepare the suspense account if any errors are located. So, what is the meaning of suspense account? So, suspense account, it is just a temporary account, isn't it? It's a temporary account which is open to balance the carry balance, which is open to balance the carry balance. How? Now, we are going to see. Two different dimensions. See, if the debit side of the carry balance exceeds the credit side, or I will explain. So, for example, this is your carry balance. See, carry balance. So, format, whatever. So, this is debit side. Okay, so debit, credit. Okay. So what they say is, if the debit side of the carry balance exceeds the credit side. So for example, so when you make it the carry balance total, our debit side comes 1 lakh. But our credit sides become total 80,000. Okay, now understood. The sentence began. If the debit side of the carry balance exceeds the credit side of the trade balance. So now you know where is the short. Credit side is the short. How much? 20,000. That's what I'm going to discuss here. See here, whatever this 1 lakh, to make it here 1 lakh, I make it here 1 lakh. So this is 20,000. I want to show difference in trade balance. Okay, difference in trade balance. That's what the meaning of here. So whenever debit side is exceed the credit side of the trade balance, so the difference is put in credit side. Understood? The difference is put in on the credit side of the trade balance. Okay. So in this case, we are going to prepare suspense account. We show as a credit balance. Okay. We have to write like this. Difference in trade balance 20,000. So we will show what? That is called suspense account. So the meaning here, while preparation of the trade balance, trade balance not tallied, because credit side 1 lakh, debit side 1 lakh, credit side only 80,000. Okay, I will make it here clearly. So when you total it, it becomes 80,000. So only 80,000. Okay, so how I will make it 1 lakh, that's what the 20,000 difference, it is called suspense account. Suspense account. So later on, we are going to identify this 20,000. How the 20,000 occurred in preparation of the trial balance? We rectify later. Once preparation of the trial balance, we found that 20,000 difference is coming. So that's what, when you open suspense account, thereafter we are going to find out how the error occurred, that how to rectify. Now understood? This is the example of whenever debit side exists. That's why I repeat once again. If the debit side of trial balance exceeds the credit side, the difference is put on the credit side of the trial balance, 20,000. Okay. So in this case, suspense account will show the credit balance. See here, here is the short, so here credit short. So I want to show that 20,000 is what? Suspense account. Okay. Here 1,80,000. So 20,000 is difference. That's what the, this is the one possibility. Now coming here, if the credit side of the trial balance exceeds, same manner. Okay, same manner. Now I will display you when you prepare the trial balance. Okay, trial balance as on same manner as a debit and credit. Okay, so when you prepare total, say it is a total, credit side same. Now credit side is 1 lakh. Okay, but debit side total, so only 80,000. In this scenario, how you have to give the effect? That's what the client is saying. If the credit side on trial balance exceeds, the debit side difference is put on the debit side of the trial balance. Okay, so how much difference? Debit short 20,000 difference. Then only you can make it at 1 lakh. So here we want debit short. Here credit short. Here debit short. This 20,000 is called what? Suspense account. So suspense account we are showing in debit side. Because credit side is exceeds than the debit side. So here we want to make the difference is called suspense account, 20,000. Later on, we are going to identify how to locate that error with the help of suspense account. Preparation of the suspense account. Understood? That's what the two possibility. So suspense account may be either debit side or credit side according to the differences affected both side. If it is both side, trial balance not tallied here. So which side is excess? As here debit side is excess, naturally 20,000 still is a short on credit balance. So I want to show in credit side only suspense account. Later on, I'm going to rectify. To prepare some suspense account, how to rectify the error, this 20,000, how the error spread over the different transactions, that is the idea. So once you take this suspense account later on, how this suspense account spread over different transactions, okay, that is the information they given. Similarly here, whenever credit side is higher, debit side is short, we show only the debit side, suspense account 20,000. Later on, going to identify the debit side of 20,000, how it was affected, why the shortage, why the debit short in 20,000 trial balance and prepare. Understood? That's what the suspense account makes a bigger role, especially for retribution and error, while after the preparation of the time balance, only the suspense upon is going to prepare. So that's what the discussion we have to continue. Now understood the meaning of the suspense account, how we have to give the effect both sides. Whenever the credit exceeds, then whenever debit exceeds, then whenever credit exceeds, how we have to work out the suspense account, how we want to show the suspense account. Whenever debit exceeds, you want to show opposite effect, natural suspense account, you want to show the credit side. Whenever credit exceeds, naturally difference coming in debit side, you want to show suspense account in debit side and trial balance. Okay. So that is information you have to keep in mind while equation of the trial balance. Okay. Now let's see the continuation about this suspense account. See, now the continuation of the meaning of suspense account, we understood now which side is short in the trial balance. Like a debit side short or credit side short, accordingly you want to mention the suspense account. Okay, that's what the point here. So errors which affect the trial balance are rectified with the help of suspense account, isn't it? So why you are preparing a suspense account? Because of the difference occurred in the trial balance. Okay. So once you prepare a suspense account, we are going to rectify the errors. That's why I try to say. So errors which affect the trial balance are rectified. So how to rectify it? With the help of the making of the suspense account. Okay. So when all the errors which affect the equality of the trial balance, that this point is very, very important. Please kindly see. See, when all the errors which affects the equality of trial balance. Okay. So the one while preparing the trial balance, definitely our debit balance and credit balance should be tally. Okay, that's what the error which affects the equality of the trial balance, this point is very important. When you make it, try to make it equality of the trial balance, are located and rectified with the help of the suspense account. There is a discussion here. So then the suspense account stands balanced. Okay. So while we are rectifying the suspense account, then now the trial balance is tallied after locating the error. After preparation of suspense account, then from the suspense account, we pick up the spreader of the error in different transactions. Later on, once suspense account is nullified, that's what they said. Once account stand is balanced, suspense account is balanced. Now the trial balance agreed the both side tally. Suppose the next point is very, very important. So, however, if the suspense accounts, even though after the suspense accounts, shows a balance after the errors have been rectified. So even though after preparation of the trial balance, once you located the suspense account because of the difference either debit side or credit side, thereafter, after preparation of the suspense account, after the suspense account, definitely some errors occur. That's what I'm trying to say. See, however, if the suspense account shows a balance even after the errors have been rectified, then this means that so there are certain errors which are yet to be rectified. Understood? So even though after preparation of the trial balance, for example, suspense account 20,000 is there, but you located maximum up to 15,000, amount of 15,000, you located the error. So still, how much is the balance? Suspense account shows 5,000. So that is the case. How you are giving effect even though after rectified in suspense account? Suppose any balance is there. That's what I'm trying to say. However, if the suspense account shows the balance even after the errors have been rectified, then this means that there are certain errors, that is very important, which are yet to be rectified. So in this case, how we are going to show that particular suspense account? I said one example. See, for example here, such a balance in suspense account is taken to the balance sheet. So in your trial balance, here I explained here, in your trial balance, you prepare as on. So whatever debit side and credit side, okay, still, so example I said, so 1 lakh Okay. Still only here only 95,000 is coming. Still 5,000. That's what here. If the debit side is, if the debit side shows a suspense account, so that's what I make it the understanding here. So here I will just change it here. So suspense account shows, so here 1 lakh total, but here only 95,000. So still that 5,000 total balance difference is coming in the debit side. So this 5,000 I still shown as a suspense account because error not located. That's what they said. See, certain errors which are yet to be located. That's why, see, even though the suspense account total 20,000, I rectified up to 15,000. Still 5,000 unable to locate. So anyway, I want to show as a suspense account debit side. If it is suspense account shown as a debit side, I will show where asset side of the balance. It went. If the debit balance, if I got debit balance, I want to show in a balancing asset side. Suppose same example here, I balance as on, as a debit, credit, so our total comes here, my debit side I got it 1 lakh, but my credit side I got it only 5,000, so still 5,000 is the difference to make it equal. So suspense upon now, which side? Suspense account, now credit side. Okay. If the suspense account still after locating the error, some error which is not located, not identified, so I want to show as a trial balance in differences for suspense account is 5,000 after activation of everything. So if it is a suspense account coming in credit side, I want to show in a liability side. You understood? That's what the meaning here. So this is the example for this one. See, any suspense account, after locating the receipt, anything possibility, unable to identify. So I want to show a suspense account, still 5,000 is a difference coming in debt balance. I want to show any asset side, any balance sheet. Similarly, any credit side difference, I want to show in a suspense account. So debit side 1 lakh, credit side still 5,000 shortage. So here, naturally, credit side short. So I want to show suspense account in credit side. So any credit side, that's what I want to show the liability side. So there is a debit balance, I want to show the asset side. That's what the example here. So there is a credit side, I want to show the liability side. You understood now. That's what the suspense account makes a major role, even though error located, identified. After that, even some errors which want yet to be rectified. So the errors, certain errors, even unable to rectify, still it shows a difference as a trial balance. You have to show in a balancing directly. So debit side, I want to show in asset side. With credit side, suspense account, I want to show the liability side. You understood? That's what the meaning of the suspense account, detailed one. So while prepare suspense account, rectify the error. Even though error is rectified, after the rectification still any differences, how they occur? Debit side, it occurred, I want to show in a balancing asset side. The credit side, it shows, so I want to show in a liability side. That's what the meaning here, I try to say. Okay, now understood the full explanation about the suspense account. Okay, now we are going to see how we have to do the suspense account rectification with the help of the idea to sort out the errors while occur after preparing the trial balance. Okay, now let's see. So now let's see, while preparation of suspense account, some important points you have to keep in your mind. Okay, now let's see the discussion there. So how the effort are going to give? See, the following points should be kept in mind. While rectifying one side error, that's why you are going to prepare what? Suspense account. The purpose of preparing suspense account, only the one side error. So the other side you want to write suspense account. That's why you have to make this effort. Okay. See here, first one. For short debit in one account. Suppose one account, debit is very short. So you want to give the effort first where which side? Debit side. That's for short debit in one account. So naturally, first debit.com. Suppose any short debit, you have to give the Apple customer debit.com. And credit side, you have to write suspense account. I understood the first word. I repeat once again. So whenever for short debit in one account, you want to give the effect word, first one in debit that account. Thereafter, credit side, you want to write suspense account. Okay, while prepare the illustration, you understood very clearly. Don't do it. Now understood the effect of for short debit, how you have to give the effect. So debit that account and credit the suspense account. Second one, excess credit in one account. Similarly, excess credit in one account. So suppose here, instead of short debit here, opposite credit side, that to excess the debit. So if it is excess credit, what do you have to do? So you want to reduce that credit, you want to make debit, isn't it? Understood very clearly. Excess credit, how will you do the effect? Debit that account. Then only the excess credit going to reduce. Understood? So we already discussed it, excess debit, excess credit. So here the excess credit in one account, how do you give the effect? Naturally, debit that account. So whatever the amount excessly accounted earlier, that particular amount, we're going to make it now debit check. Debit that account. Naturally, opposite what? Credit in the suspense account. Similarly, same manner. The only thing, excess credit, give the effect only in debit check. Okay, to reduce our excess credit. Understood the second important one. Now, third. Third is the comparison of this. Okay. Short credit. See here, short credit. How the short debit we discussed here. Here, short credit. So naturally, as a short credit, so you have to give first effect where? Credit that account first. Correct, isn't it? So any short credit in one account, first you have to give the effect only the credit side. So now debit side, you have to write the suspense account. You understood the meaning of this? Debit side. The suspense account. So, which side we are going to write the suspense account, that is very, very important. So, when you give the one side error, the other account is called suspense account. That is the creation of the understanding. Short credit, naturally in one account, first you have to give the effect in credit check, credit that account, and debit the suspense account. Understood the third example. Now, finally, this is the comparison of fourth example. Same matter. So, the fourth example, excess debit. How here excess credit? Here excess debit. So naturally, you want to reduce debit, you want to make it first to your credit side. That's what? Credit debt account. Understood now? The same manner here. So to reduce your excess debit, you want to give effect in excess debit. So you want to make the reduce the amount, that particular amount. So you have to give the effect. How you are going to give the effect? Make credit debt account. So naturally, debit part, you want to write suspense account. You understood? So naturally, debit part, write the suspense account. That's what, first comparison between short debit and short credit. That's what this comparison, you can easily understood. How you have to give. Second one, excess credit and excess debit. See, any excess credit, your first effort is what? Debit side. Any excess debit, your effort is credit side. So wherever, opposite, you can write suspense account. So here, because of one side error, other side, you can't show openly, correct? You can't show just like that, one side. So, to compensate that, see any errors occur accordingly, you have to give the one side error. After that, you want to write suspense account. So maybe debit side and credit side. That's what you should know very well, where you are going to write, which side suspense account will come. Accordingly, you want to sort out, to rectify the amount of the suspense balance, any balance available suspense account up to rectify. So understood, this is the important discussion for while do the suspense account for one side error. Okay, understood. That's what the for short debit, so opposite short credit. Excess credit opposite, excess debit. Accordingly, how they are given the effect here. Okay, understood. Okay, now with the example, definitely you have some idea to preparation of the suspense account. Don't definitely you can be able to understand. So now we will see suspense account with the help of the example illustration. This one by one are going to do the rectification. See, what is the first one? Rectify the following errors. C sales returns from Vega 1600 was posted her account. Posted her account as 1000. So this is the error occurred. I read once again. Sales returns from Vega, how much? 1600 was posted to her account as 1000. So now how we are going to rectify? Before that, first of all, you want to know actually what happened. So actually, what is the transaction wrongly occurred? They wrongly entered. See, as you know, sales return from Mega. So what is the entry? You know very well. So as a sales. So first the discussion. Okay, sales return account data 1600 to Mega account. So this is the general entry we're going to pass, isn't it? 1600. Okay. So this is about the transaction. Okay. So sales return from Mega 1600. If they return the general entry like this, there is no error. But what happened was posted her account as 1000. So the sales return, they've done it correctly. So debit side is correct. On the credit side, Mega her account, they return only 1000. So what happened here? Credit short. How much? Instead of 1600, they return 1000. So how much difference you have to write? So you have to write for credit debt amount. Understood now? For his understanding, to Mega account 600. That's what the credit short. So now we are going to account credit side. So naturally debit side what? That's what? Now we are going to write suspense account. Suspense account. Data 600. You understood what the effect of this? Clearly understood. So this is the entry they occurred what? Short credit. You understood. This is coming under what? Error resulting credit side in a Mega's account, they return only 1000 instead of 1600. So how much again going to do the credit side of Mega's account? 600. Okay, that's why I am going to write to Mega's account 600, to suspense account 600. Here debit part I am going to make it suspense account. Okay. That's what the effect of the first entry. You understood. So that is the information we are going to discuss now. It is Vaishnav entry. Okay. So now you understood how we are going to give the effect of the first one. Clearly understood now. So before that, first you make it to try to how we are going to learn. First you make the entry. What is the correct entry here? For understanding purpose. This is the entry only we are going to do. This is the rectification entry. Okay, rectification entry. So directly also you can do it. So first you have to learn what is the correct entry. So then you understood what happened. Then you are going to rectification entry, suspense account data 600 to Mega's account 600. So why I am debiting suspense account? So this is the portion nil. So that's why I am posted here suspense account. Only the credit side only because of the short credit. Okay, short credit, I am going to make it extra 600. I am going to make it her account. First posted her account only 1000. So again, I want to make it 600 rupees extra. That's what? To Mega's account 600. So understood? Example about this, first one, now see. Let's see. I give you time for that. Okay, you understood? Now, the second one. See, cash paid to Mega 2000 was not posted her account. Means what? So we paid to Mega 2000. So what is the entry? Again, entry I write, second one. What is the entry? Mega account data 2000 to cash account. Okay, that's what the entry. Cash paid to Mega. This is the entry I am going to pass. So what happened? Was not posted to her account. So this entry they not done it. So debit part, they not done it very clearly. Okay. So debit part, they not done it very clearly. Credit part, in a cash account, they done it posted. So only they not posted properly. When they open mega account, they not posted. Two cash account, they not done it. But in a cash account, they done it by mega account 2000. But in a mega account, two cash, that transaction, they not mentioned in mega account. When you open a mega account, ultimately how you are going to post them? In a open a mega account, so I will explain. In a mega account, so when you open a mega account, asset credit side, so you have to make it what? Two cash account. 2000. Okay. So this part not posted. So this part they not done it. Okay. So how you have to give the effect? So that's what going to give the effect what? What is the rectification entry? So debit part only they not done it. That's what you have to make it mega account. Account debtor 2000 to suspense account. Suspense account 2000. Understood. The example of second. Clearly understood now. That's what you have to read the transaction very carefully. So before that you want to know what is the correct entry. Then only you can able to identify the error occurred. Okay. So the cash paid to mega account 2000. But unfortunately what happened? Was not posted to our account. So naturally debit what we want. So debit that account. Debit that amount. That's what debit that amount. Mega account 2000. So credit part, it is your account show blankly. That's why you are going to write two suspense account 2000. Now understood the second example to prepare of the suspense account. Now third one. So depreciation written off on furniture 1500 was not posted into depreciation account. They totally forget to write the depreciation account. Okay. So how they give the effect? Okay, I will clean this. Third one. So third one, posting, totally they omitted. Depreciation written off on furniture. Later on you can able to discuss detailly depreciation. So you want to show in a furniture account, then only the furniture account will show, reduce the value of the furniture value. Whenever for posting this depreciation, to find out our cost of the furniture as on now. Right? So you can discuss detail in our depreciation chapter. So now here, any depreciation, they are not posted in furniture account. Okay. In the depreciation account, they not done it. So now what you have to do? That's what debit part you want to do. That is rectification entry is what? Depreciation account. So this is rectification entry. So you want to write like this, rectification entry. Okay. So here, rectification entry. Rectification. Okay, so what they said, depreciation written off furniture 1500 not posted to depreciation account. So they totally omitted. So error of omission, so not posted. That's what now going to write depreciation account. The debit part, how much? 1500. The credit part to suspense account. Understood. Because only one side error. So, to suspense account. 1500. You understood. Or, add one. Okay. So, I hope that now you understood it. Add one. A fourth one. See, credit sales to Morgan. Credit sales to Morgan. But, to his account, 1000. So, what is the error occurred? Okay, the fourth one. First, you see the entry is what? So, what is the correct entry? What is the correct entry? Credit sales to Morgan. You know very well. Morgan account data. See, Morgan account data. How much we sold actually? 10,000. Okay, 10,000. To what? Sales account. Sales account. 10,000. This is what our correct entry. But what happened? See, this account, they debited 12,000 instead of 10,000. So, instead of 10,000, They had done it how much? 12,000. So what happened? Excess debit. How much? 2,000. Understood? So excess debit how much? 2,000. So 2,000. Excess debit. Okay. So what is the rectification entry? Now let's see. Very easy one. That's why before that you want to make the entry, the correct entry first. Then only then able to understand very clearly how the error occurred. Then how to give the rectification. Thank you. Okay. So now let's see. So Morgan account returned to sales account. So sales part they done it correct. 10,000. But what happened? This account, instead of 10,000, they done it what? 12,000. This is wrong. So how much excess debit? 2,000. So how to do? So any excess debit, naturally to reduce that, you make it credit part. Correct. So to Morgan account. How much? 2,000. Rectification entry. Rectification. How understood? To reduce of more than this 2,000, I'm going to credit because of excess debit. So reduce that, I make it credit to Morgan account 2,000. So debit part what? Debit part is suspense account. Suspense. And better 2,000. So understood. For the effect of this notification. So that's what you can clearly able to understood first very strongly what is the correct journal entry with the help of personal account, real account, non-real account. So once you are strong in the preparation of formation of journal entries, our rectification of chapter, rectification of errors chapter is very, very easy and very interesting. That is very, very important. You can do the exercise with the interest. How? When you are strong in the formation of journal entries. So then only this chapter is make very interesting to you to rectify the error. Correct. That's what the idea here under the suspense account. Why the suspense account prepared? Because of the one side error. So opposite you are going to prepare. Here credit side, you return suspense account. Here debit side, write the suspense account. Accordingly, this two examples will done it. Okay. So accordingly you want to practice that for suspense account when will come. While after preparing the cash balance, any error occurred. You want to open a suspense account. After that, you want to clear the that rectify errors in suspense account. So we discussed a very important point. Even though after opening a suspense account, still any suspense account balance. If it is debit part, you want to show in a balance sheet asset side. If it is credit part in a suspense account, you want to show in a liability side. Okay, that you have to keep in your mind. Even though unable to locate the error. That is a very, very important point. Okay. So I hope that you understood this session of suspense account very, very important with the help of this illustration. So thereafter, we'll discuss detail in our NCERT exercise. So please see the video many times. Then only this chapter, you can be able to understand and you can be able to follow. Before that, you should be strong in the journal entries, preparation of journal entries with the help of what? The rule, golden rule. It is called golden rule. What is that? Personal account, real account, non-real account. What is the personal account rule? I repeat now here once again. What is the personal account rule? Debit the receiver, credit the giver. What is the real account rule? Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. What is the non-real account rule? Debit all expenses and losses. Credit all income and gain. Likewise, you want to keep in that rule regularly in your mind. So whenever you do for the rectification of errors. Before that, you should be making yourself strong in formation of journal entry. Then only this chapter, rectification of error, is very interesting. Okay, so that's why I request you to please make it strong, the formation of journal entry. Okay, I hope that you understood for the suspense account. Then, further videos discuss about the problems, how to work out the problem. Okay, in the meantime, you have to work out in our NCERT book exercise according to our once we receive the. Okay, so thank you very much.